What's up guys, AT here, and today I'm going to show you how to import data from Excel to DataGridView in an easy way. Okay, before we start, we need some requirements. The first one, you need to go to browser, open up your browser and type in Access Driver or Microsoft Access Driver Database Engine. And in here, you're gonna click on download and you're gonna download, choose it based on your OS. Choose whatever it is. Maybe it's 64-bit or 32-bit. After it's get downloaded, you can come here, start the install and wait for it to install. Okay, let's get back to our code. I'm gonna create a function here to get the previous code in my previous video in this function, so we don't need to use it, but we don't need to delete it. So I'm gonna press Ctrl X and Ctrl V here to cut and paste. Now I'm gonna create another function, which is called the easy way to load. So I'm gonna type in private void easy way to load. Oh, yes, like this. Just like that. Now I'm gonna come up here and add some reference libraries. I'm gonna type in using system.data.oledb. Now let's get back down here and type in try catch. We're gonna use a try catch block to catch any errors and or unexpected or unwanted errors. Make sure to subscribe me and leave a like down here. It will actually help my channel to grow. Now, catch exception ex message box dot show, and in that I'm gonna type in ex dot message. Just that. We don't need anything else. Now, in the try block, I'm gonna type in the connection string. I'm gonna make the connection string, and for your convenience, I'm gonna put this text or this line down in the description below so you can use it. Now we can use the file name underline lbl.txt, which is our label that I put in our previous video, to actually have the path to the Excel file. Now let's create object instances. OLEDB connection con equals new connection, and it's using our connection string or con str. Now OLEDB data adapter, we're going to use a data adapter for that. I'm going to use new data adapter, and we're going to use OLCMD. We don't have that right now, but I'll get to it. The CMD is actually the command. We're gonna actually type an SQL command to do it. Let's type in select. Syntax of SQL, select a star means select everything from the sheet number one. And as you can see, it works right now. And then we're gonna add the connection, our connection to it. Let's type in dataset, data set, ds equals new dataset. As you can see, we get an error under the dataset statement. That's why, because we didn't add the library of the data. So we'll come up here and type in using system.data, just like that. And we get back down here, and as you can see, the error is gone. Now, we're going to assign the database to, or assign the data set to the DataGridView data source. So first of all, we fill the data set and then we assign it to the DataGridView data source, just like this, data underline GRD, which is our DataGridView dot data source equals DS dot table number zero. You know, numbers start from zero in, you know, the computer science. And then we're going to type con.close to close the connection after the data is being pulled from the XFI. Now in here, we're going to call the function and then we're going to start and run the application to see what happens. Now let's load our file, this here import. Okay, now we have an error here. It says the Microsoft dot whatever provider is not registered on the local machine. We need some requirements for that. The first requirement, we did it already. We need to do the second requirement, which is declare CPU type. Come over here, over configuration manager, and add a CPU type of your own OS. Mine is 64-bit, so I'm gonna add 64-bit. Okay, now let's start. Load the file, import, and here it is. As you can see, the Excel file is here. All here, easy way. So this is the most easiest thing that we could do. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification button so you get notified when the new video is uploaded.